The rules of business decision making more often than not are based on the principle of I win, you lose. Companies, and their employees, proceed invincibly down the path of unilateral rightness. Compromise is out of the question. Collaboration is tantamount to defeat. I win. You lose. Damn the consequences. Now, I'm not going to say, I win, you lose, never happens. Sure it does. In fact, it makes complete sense, in certain situations. For example, it's the only way to approach competitors because market share is more or less a zero-sum game. But otherwise, that's neither the way to win nor the way it works in the real world. Frankly, I don't know where Mortimer's assertion comes from, but it's not consistent with my experience. So, to clear up all the confusion and distinguish between the different approaches, here are five ways to win in any business situation. Internal relationship between co-workers. Win-win, collaborate, all the way. Anything else is dysfunctional. Sure, the dysfunctional stuff, backstabbing, taking credit for someone else's work, sugarcoating BS, CYA, all exists, but don't fall into that trap. You either have to play it smarter or find a company that doesn't accept that kind of crap. Goal, win-win boss-employee relationship. Again, win-win, collaborate, all the way, same as with co-workers. Companies don't exist for you, your boss, or your employees. They exist for two reasons, to provide a product or service to customers, and to provide value to shareholders. All employees at every level should be aligned to do that, simple as that. Goal, win-win competitors in the marketplace. I win, you lose. Period. Market competition is a zero-sum game, simple as that. To suggest otherwise is idiotic. And yes, you should befriend your competitors, call them frenemies, hang out and party with them, anything you like. Just listen more than you talk. Keep your friends close and your enemies closer, right? Goal, I win, you lose customer-vendor relationship. Customer-vendor relationships should always yield the perception of a win-win, especially if you want an ongoing relationship. That said, when you approach negotiations, your goal is to get the better deal while the other guy thinks he did okay too. I think of that as, I win, you don't lose. CAMP provides a pretty good approach for doing that. It's not easy at first, but you do get better at it with experience. Goal, I win, you don't lose job or consulting opportunity. It's important to note that, in this situation, you all have to live with each other after the fact. So, whichever side of the equation you're on, don't overpromise and risk underdelivering or underplay your hand and risk losing the gig. Best to be genuine. That said, when it comes to negotiating dollars and cents, it's the same as customer-vendor. Goal, I win, you don't lose hope that helps to clear things up. Now go negotiate something. Win-win is a situation, game, negotiation, or strategy in which all the parties benefit one way or another, there are no losers. In a conflict situation, when the participants are trying to work out a resolution, a win-win strategy is one in which everybody is accommodated, all participants come out winning. There are many different types of outcomes, everybody might win, one might gain while the other loses, or all parties come out losing. A win-win situation or result is one that is good for everyone who is involved. Flexible working hours are a win-win situation for employers and employees. In a win-win situation, both parties come out on top. In a zero-sum or win-lose situation, however, there is just one winner, the other party, or other parties, losers, lose. In the 1980s, how individuals approached negotiations began to change considerably. Rather than thinking that the result always had to be a winner and a loser, many people came to see that win-win negotiations were not only an improvement on the traditional win-lose mindset, but also more desirable, i.e. if all parties believe there is a good chance that they will benefit from the negotiation, they are more likely to take part in it and contribute. As the concept of everybody winning grew in the world of negotiations, so did confusion about exactly what it entailed. Did it mean that each party came out with equal portions of the pie, or that one would have a bigger slice than the others? Surely, if one participant had more to offer, they should get more of that pie, shouldn't they? If people enter a win-win negotiation, does that mean that they still continue fighting for their corner? Do they still try to gain as much as possible for themselves? The answer to that question is a definite yes. Win-win negotiation doesn't require you to split resources right down the middle with a sole focus on being fair. It doesn't mean automatically making a concession just because the other party made one. And it doesn't mean that you should try to avoid conflict and tension at all cost. Sometimes, all it takes to transform a seemingly lose-lose situation into a win-win one is a little bit of imagination, consideration and cooperation. When you are participating in a win-win negotiation, your aim is to work to get the best deal you can for yourself, while at the same time attempting to make sure that the other party is satisfied. It means making offers that are good for you and also for them. You need to think creatively about how you can help your counterpart and also getting more for yourself.Win-win, in this type of situation, everybody comes out winning. Zero-sum or win-lose, is a situation in which only one party wins, while the other loses, this is an adversarial approach. Lose-lose or negative-sum, is a situation in which every party loses, nobody wins. All these different terms came from asterisk-asterisk game theory. Effective win-win negotiations are the cornerstone of successful deals and help establish long-lasting mutually beneficial relationships.There are times in the course of building a business that it's imperative to create win-win situations, hint, all the time. Perhaps you're white labeling someone's services, acting as the middlewoman, or partnering with another company or organization for an event or new initiative launch. Whatever it is, the art of creating win-win situations can be broken down into a science when empathy is at the forefront of the decisions. A true win-win achieves at least the minimum goal for all parties and entails a great deal of understanding.Regardless of your specific business situation, consider these best practices for finding win-wins with potential partners and clients. The first and most fundamental step is simply to understand everyone's outcome priorities. What is everyone's overarching goal from this partnership or deal? Put on your broker cap to get an outside view of the best terms for everyone. I always take a step back and then put myself in the shoes of both parties, said Debazorgi.The simple question is, what is the benefit to each party of working with each other? If the benefit isn't immediately tangible, it's not worth even presenting. Of course, to fully know what the benefit is to each party, make sure there's an open conversation about everyone's priorities. Some may surprise you. Communication is key for this alignment. Next, see beyond the one deal and treat all negotiations as part of a larger relationship.You can't successfully create win-win situations consistently unless you've actually built long-term relationships with potential business partners, notes Debazorgi. When you treat these partners as long-term friends and connections, the stakes become different. Maybe a specific deal or partnership isn't working or aligning in the way you'd hoped today, but because of how you handle that conversation and how consistently you stay in touch, a different type of partnership can emerge later on.Generally speaking, approaching any type of negotiation with a long-term relationship in mind changes the dynamic of the conversation, and can help the person you're negotiating with feel that you have their best interest at heart. Finally, if negotiations aren't going as planned and little progress is being made, Harvard Law School's Program on Negotiation blog recommends a contingent agreement. In it, the parties list out how they envision potential scenarios playing out.Then, a discussion about each scenario's requirements and expectations occurs. A breakthrough is likely to happen here. Like the name suggests, the agreement lists contingency clauses. For example, maybe the final payment is only contingent on a certain number of attendees at a partnered event. Or, maybe the partnership can be called off if results don't meet a certain threshold within the first 90 days. This creates a cushion or safety net for the parties, making a win-win feel more plausible.Finding win-win situations can feel challenging, but by prioritizing a long-term relationship, seeking to understand and align values, and creating contingency clauses, the negotiations can be more swift and ultimately, more fruitful.